Everybody, remember, well, first of all, if you're just joining us late, hi, I'm Dan Amrick. I'm the community developer for Rocksmith 2014, and you're watching a very live stream from here in Studio San Francisco, the development studio which Dunn made Rocksmith. And you may recognize this cheery British fellow as the cheery British fellow from the beginning of that video. This is Paul Cross. You were creative director, but now you have ascended even higher to director of design.
Sounds fancy, eh?
It sounds super great. What does director of design entail? Do you just look at people's game concepts and say no? Or yes, but?
Yes.
So you have the job in gaming that every gamer out there thinks is like the only, oh, I can come up with ideas for games. I can tell you what how to make that game better. That's kind of, you're living their dream. So well done.
Thanks, Dan.
Yeah, when you think about it that way.
I didn't think you were going to give me this kind of intro. I thought it'd be like, hey, everyone, have a go at Paul.
Oh, hey, everyone. Everybody who watches knows we're a very supportive bunch here. Even when I screw up, they go, well, nice try. You know, they don't say get.
Well, they say yes, but.
Yes, but. Yes, but. You should have probably hit at least half of the notes in the song.
So what does a creative director do? So, yeah, it's not actually my job to come up with all the ideas. The important aspect is that I listen to everybody's ideas, which includes sometimes ideas from out on the interwebs, and then try and make sure we choose the right ones to execute, because we can't do everything.
Right.
So really that's the main
role. You're a sculptor.
Yeah.
You're a curator of ideas.
And so the difference between a creative director and a director of design
Yes.
is that I direct creative directors now.
Oh, all right.
So it'll be over multiple projects without giving too much away.
So to suggest that now you're, as director of design, you can now bring a little Paul Cross magic to multiple titles and not just Rocksmith.
I think managing a little Studio SF magic across multiple titles
is the
important thing. It's
well,
a team effort.
I think people know that there's something else in the works because we've been hiring people. So,
yes.
Yes, but we'll see. There will be a time, and you will understand what we're talking about. Brian Pody is also here, off the wheels of steel. Hi, Brian.
Hello.
And thank you, Anthony, for jumping on the wheels. So let's see. We've been trying to get you on here for a long time, and I said, you don't have to play guitar if you don't want to. You're like, no, I need to play guitar because I didn't play guitar before Rocksmith, and I really want to show people, like, I feel like a poster boy to a certain extent. So you have put an awful lot of pressure. You put an awful lot of pressure on yourself to do this, and I was like, well, just relax. And so you're going to do lead guitar on You Give Love a Bad Name by Bon Jovi, which is this week's backtrack. If you have not checked out Brian Pody, now Brian Pody has tracked this and he wrote up the backtrack with a really interesting little trivia factoid that I did not know about like where the song came from and the writer of the song. So you should definitely check our forums today. It's out there. I've also talked about it on Twitter a little bit. But you have tracked this and you have not gotten to play the lead guitar part, which is what normally the tracker would do.
No.
Last time we played it, why didn't you play lead guitar last time?
Because I played Living on a Prayer.
Oh,
that's
right.
Two songs that I tracked because I said, oh, Brian, Bon Jovi is coming up. Can I do all of them?
And then you grew to regret that anyway. So you're going to play bass. You're going to give this a shot at lead. I think you're fine. My desk is two desks away from yours. I hear every time you practice, you've been playing this extremely well. So even if he screws it up.
He's so sweet. When I screw it up.
Even if he screws it up, just know that it's the lights and it's the echo. You guys knew, we've talked about this. There's a little echo for us here in the room. And it does make it a little bit more challenging to play this
Wouldn't
thing
that
accurately.
Be ironic if I complained about latency.
But no, this is artificial stream latency. This is not program latency. If you just watch the screen and listen to both of your ear cups, you'll be fine. So put those ear cups on.
On the stream is like a 100% different experience than playing at home or at
your desk. Gonna fill him with confidence.
Well,
way to go, Brian.
I'll cross my legs so I don't wet myself.
Yeah, there we go.
Just all right. From my perspective.
Give this a try. This is from the Bon Jovi pack, of course, that was released in the fall, right after early December, actually. It was the first week of December. Yeah. And I'm happy to say that if you are one of those users, one of the players in Europe or territories served by the European PlayStation Store on PlayStation, that DLC finally came out. So this song is now available to you as well. So let's give it a shot. You Give Love a Bad Name. I'll try to keep my chatter to a minimum so as not to distract you. But normally, I chat all the way through. But out of decency for you, And since you have...
Okay. You can call me out when I miss it. I missed it.
Paul, you're missing something important. When I said, yeah, I'd love to work at Ubisoft, you helped that happen. So... Is duly impressed in the chat room.
I need to do some work. I haven't done any work for 3 weeks.
I know, you've just been practicing. It's like, you know, now you have to start going to meetings again. Wow, very good. Look at that, 95% on guitar, 97% on bass. Exceptional performance. Rocksmith guy even likes you. Yeah, well, you know, you got to get a bassist. If it wasn't for his support, I'm sure you wouldn't have been able to get through it. That was super great.
Sorry.
Congratulations,
not
you
bad.
Made it. No,
not
sorry.
Bad. I missed a couple.
But you're one of these people that had not played guitar seriously before Rocksmith. Had you played at all? Had you even, like, tried a little bit?
So I've told a few people, my idea of playing guitar was this is a chord, right?
Right.
I had no sense of tuning, anything else. Sometimes the guitar, when you hold it like this, sounded all right. And I'd played noodle about when I was about, I don't know, six. Mm-hmm. But that's it. Never had a lesson. It's all Rocksmith. In fact, the note trackers that's in behind you, I'm just like, I hardly even ask them stuff because I'm always like, no, don't tell me. Make sure it's in the game
right.
So the game can actually tell me.
You're the control group, really, to make sure that this software works.
Pretty much. And we have a number of people like that on the team. In fact, one of the strangest things about Studio SF is people think, oh, they're the Rocksmith studio. It's like, well, sort of, no, we're a video game studio.
That happens to
that
do.
Our first titles were Rocksmith.
What about the Smurfs? Let's talk about the Smurfs.
Very successful.
The Smurfs, a lot of people
actually work on it. But
That's all right. But that's what the studio did before.
Yeah,
Rocksmith, right?
We worked on Pets titles. We worked on Now and I worked on No More Heroes 2.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah, which is a nice sort of family-friendly, decapitating
yeah.
type game. Family-unfriendly.
Oh, yeah, there we go. The secret history of Studio SF. So I do have a couple of questions that came up during that. One, they can't place your accent where are you from within the UK.
Within the UK.
Yeah.
So we got that far.
Well, no, they got that far. No, they okay. they don't think you're Australian. They didn't give you the, you know.
So this is where I go, so you know London?
Yeah.
Do you know Guildford?
Yeah.
You're saying yeah.
Well, yeah, I don't, well, we don't have it in real time. There's a delay.
So, okay, so near Guildford, then we can go smaller town, Camberley, and then we can go smaller than that, Lightwater.
All right.
So basically, it normally goes right back to the top, just southeast of London.
Just southeast of London. Sorry. In light water, which is great. Like so there's, I thought those things only existed in D&D campaigns.
They should.
I moved.
What can I say?
you can't go home again, and now they won't even let you in.
No,
so
it's just a difference. Like some people look at their life and they go, "I really want to get out of the small town I'm growing up
sure.
in," and other people say, "I want to stay in the small town I'm growing up in." And
sure.
I was the former. I wanted to get away from it. Not because it was necessarily bad, it just wasn't for me.
Sure. So, running joke every week in the chat, insert instrument here, end it with Smith. Piano Smith, drum Smith, bagpipe Smith, song Smith, Dan Smith, unfortunately, was coined last week.
I did notice somebody had hacked your face.
Yes. So, yeah, there's, let's call it fan art of my face as an inlay on the guitar. This will not.
You know it's my desktop now, right?
I was afraid you would say that. Realistically, though, people always say, well, I love how Rocksmith has taught me how to play guitar. Have you considered adding or bringing out a new edition for Drumsmith or Pianosmith or any of the other popular instruments that people often want to learn how to play? Is this something that you've considered?
Considered, absolutely. The question is the right format. So at the moment, we're obviously on consoles. That might change very soon. which there's been pictures of Now and I touching it.
I don't know what you're talking about, and we ignore those questions on a regular weekly basis. This interview is over. but yeah,
it's gonna happen. So you're gonna get a Rocksmith on iOS at some point. Before you ask when, I can't give you an answer to that right this second for various reasons, licensing. but once we get to that point, and that comes out, and people buy it. Then we can start talking about all the dramatic. Oh, hello.
Hello.
Oh,
sorry, people
me.
Are having trouble hearing you.
Do I have to start again?
No.
So iOS, yeah, it's going to happen.
It's going to happen.
And then assuming that people go and actually buy it and use it, then I can have conversations with the people that write the big checks about, wouldn't it be cool if there was a piano smith?
Right.
Or a monkey smith or whatever.
Ooh.
There we go. because those things then can actually
build.
Be compatible with it. It works. You could actually use it. But we need to get to a point where we could convince people who write big checks.
Right.
Just brutally honest.
I'm looking at... Oh, somebody said why did certain things disappear from Rocksmith 1, like being able to practice for a gig, the campaign mode, things like that. Why was that removed from Rocksmith 2014? Because they miss it.
Because Rocksmith 1's foundations were flaky. So we basically rewrote the entire game. So when you go to do that, you have to look at the scope of the project. And so we put first and foremost the best way to learn, or the fastest, the definitive, pick a noun and say the best way to learn guitar. And when we looked at career mode against that, it took a lower priority and just wasn't going to make our release schedule.
Okay.
Again, sorry. So it's
fine.
Personally, I believe in it, but we needed to make the great tool first and foremost. And I think Rocksmith 2014 is an amazing tool. It's not as gamified as Rocksmith 1. And I'm a gamer. I mean, you know, when I come in here and I say I'm going to practice, I'm going to play at 100%, and I look at my score and go, damn it, I've gotten higher. And I'm like, oh, man, because I'm a gamer. That's right, what I want to do. I want to go and beat scores. So I'm still, even when I'm playing a guitar, I want to show how good I am at it. Maybe not to the world. I'm still blushing. So I'm wearing the orange shirt. <all right>. But those sensations were really strong in Rocksmith 1, and we lost them a little bit in Rocksmith 2014. But again, like, we listen to what the community is saying. So if we were perhaps designing a future Rocksmith at the moment, it's the sort of thing that we would take into consideration. The community, our active community, is saying we really wanted that. Then we will push the priorities accordingly. Especially now, I'm pointing at the screen of Rocksmith 2014.
Yeah.
Now we have a great tool. We have things like instant riff repeater, and we have no loading, and all these features which were time consuming to create.
There is a maybe 70 or 80 thread, a page thread on our forums, which is just feedback and recommendations and suggestions for the. And I don't know if people realize this, but that has now been condensed into an actual document that lives on our servers for when we do get to start dreaming about, like, what if we get the chance to make another game? What would we want? What would they want? You know, what would that look like? That's all there. So, like, your feedback has not been wasted. You may not see some of the changes in 2014 that you're like, oh, I wish that you would just, like, add 5-string bass, for instance. It's very popular. You know, oh, that's a pretty big consideration. But it's something that's on the list for, if we get a chance, we'll revisit that idea. So it's good. I have one last question for you, and then you can go, because I know you have a 4 o'clock meeting. Derek Henry says, what's great about having Paul on your crew is that he's like me, where I've learned everything from Rocksmith. So my question to Paul is, do you have any suggestions that only a beginner who has only learned from Rocksmith would think of? Do you have? I think he's asking, do you have any suggestions for, if you have only learned through Rocksmith, where do you go from there? What should you be aware of as you improve at guitar?
If your hand hurts, stop playing for a bit.
This is surprisingly... A lot of people say they play through the pain, and it's absolutely the wrong thing to do.
Yeah. So the interesting thing, when you're finishing a video game, especially in my role, I'll sit there and I will play for 10 to 15 hours a day, 6 days a week for a good few months. And it was no different with Rocksmith. So yeah, I've had an intense course, but by the end of it, my hand hurt. And so I stopped playing for a long time after Rocksmith 2014 because I was worried I was doing serious damage.
Sure.
And I need my gaming thumbs. So I think that's something to really, really bear in mind. Play a variety of songs. I think that's really important. Challenge yourself with different things. And don't just try and perfect one song early. Like, the stuff you really want to play tends to be a little harder. Mm-hmm. Like, early on, I was like, right, I want to learn to play Plug-in Baby. But the only way I could progress on it was by going and playing a bunch of other songs, getting my hand used to the motions, the movement, and building up that confidence and speed without getting frustrated banging my head against the brick wall of Mr. Bellamy's playing.
Sure. It's more of an additive thing. You know, like, you can learn a lot from a lot of different songs that will then, in turn, enhance all the other songs you want to learn. Mm-hmm. And I think you're right. I think too often people get tunnel vision and go, no, I just want to learn Foo Fighters songs. Or I just want to learn this one Foo Fighters song, and I'm not going to go to sleep until I get it at, you know, X percent. And yet, if you would just sort of let yourself shift gears, you know,
actually, you brought up a really, really interesting point, and something I've been noticing as we've been expanding the DLC more and more. Of actually, Foo Fighters, great example. We've got a lot of songs with Dave Grohl at the helm, and you notice how he plays guitar. Mm-hmm. So what you start to do is, actually, if you switch between all the different Foo Fighters songs, you are going to be building a set of skills that will help you perfect Foo Fighters songs,
right.
which is kind of cool. And then you start to see some of the patterns of other guitarists and the correlation. There's plenty of songs I fire off now where I go, whoa, I can't play this style of guitar. And then there are others where I'm like, yes, power chords.
Right. Yeah, this fits in my wheelhouse and I don't have to think too hard.
I feel like this should be an amazing third point, but I haven't got one.
You've got a 4 o'clock meeting too. Do you want to show off your guitar? Because you've got the best guitar in the office, right? Like, I think we all kind of agree that this 2011 Gibson Nighthawk is probably, this is the perk of power. When you're Paul Cross, director of design, you say, that guitar lives at my desk.
Oh yeah, it's a bit of a rescue puppy. So when we were making Rocksmith 1, we knew that we needed to make really nice, high-quality videos showing people how to play the guitar, how to hold the guitar, all the bass, how to hold a pick. And we wanted to make sure we had nice guitars, but we didn't have the Gibson deal in place.
Ah.
So we were like, okay, what are we going to do? Typically, people would make custom guitars. They do things like put gaffer tape over the logo, because only certain parts of guitars are actually protected.
Right.
So we started to buy some guitars that we were then going to customize beyond recognition. Try how much I can say. We didn't do it. We have great friends at Gibson.
A lot of people's first guitars have been customized beyond recognition, right. Actually. So we
did that. But before we went and butchered the poor things, we actually got the deal signed with Epiphone and Gibson and started being big good buddies with them. And I said, well, don't send her back to the shop. We need nice guitars, right?
Right.
she can live with me.
This one's mine. Yeah.
It's not my guitar. It's a work.
It's the office's
guitar.
But
it just happens to live next to my desk, and people say it's Paul's guitar. And
right.
Tend
well, it's
to
the
take
same thing
away.
with the Blue Les Paul. It's sort of it lives with me. It belongs to the office. Anybody can play it. But you're sort of the steward.
So one of our projects that's not a Rocksmith title that's coming in the future. One of the guys came and he was like, "Can I have a guitar at my desk?" And we're like, "Yeah,
yes." It's part of the culture of the studio.
That's what
really
we do here now. If you want to sit and play guitar a bit. Cool.
Yeah,
have fun.
The first week I was here, I was actually taken to task by Peter, because he's like, how come you don't have a guitar at your desk yet? You play guitar. Why don't you have a guitar? I'm like, I didn't know which one was mine. He goes, take any one you want. Look, here's one. He ran over, got a stand, put an Epiphone SG on my desk. He goes, there you go. That's your guitar until you find one that you like more. I'm like, okay. Like, I didn't want to be too forward.
You've got three in a little workshop.
Yeah, I've got three
apart,
in a little workshop
stuff.
Where I'm soldering them and putting new strings on your Nighthawk. Yeah, so
that's probably why I missed a couple of notes.
It's all right. Yeah, yes, you can blame it on me. I will take the hit for that. Okay, now I officially have to kick you out because we have another song to go.
So
thank you very much.
A pleasure. I will come back.
I would love that.
I'm pointing at the internet. Here.
That's the internet here, in case you're wondering.
Smaller than I remember.
Yeah.
And we'll talk.
What's new?
We'll talk.
Okay.
Like, I think that'll be fun. I think it's nice for me. I want to hear what people have to say, but having a back and forth is really especially interesting.
Sure.
And not just using permanent conduit for all that information.
We have we generally save the chat logs, so I'll send all your chat logs straight to Paul when we're done. We can review it later on, and I'd love to have you back on again.
Cool.
Thanks, man.
I'll have to practice another song now.
Yeah, I know. You choose what you want, and we'll play it because you're director of design. So
that's love you guys.
And thank you, Brian, for standing there attentively and listening to the stories. I'm so sorry.
It's interesting to me.